In this session, we have to learn how to integrate Dialogflow with Google Calendar. I have some root.txt where we can do step by step. So the first step is create a Dialogflow agent. So we can go according to it. Let's do it. Okay, this is the Dialogflow ES console. We need to create a new agent from here. Let's name it reminder bot and just create. It will take 1 or 2 minutes. Okay, agent is created and now it is done. And create a reminder.add intent. Here the two default intents. One is welcome intent and other one is fallback. We have to create a new intent. Let's say it is reminder.add, where we can add some events of calendar, and here we can add some training pages like reminder add, or we can say that remind me to just remind me to eat. Or we can say that remind me to eat on tomorrow at 8 PM, and we need to specify that this will our event. So I will say it is any entity, and let's name it event name. And here the date. Okay, I will consider it is only date. Just it is date, and this will be the time. Here we have three entities like event name and date and time. The action parameter that if we okay here specify that the event name. So wait, so here we can define the prompts like what be the name of this event. Okay, and we also can define the date. If you don't give the date, it will be asking for the date. What is and then define the time. and we can enable the fulfillment and save it. The response we have to give from the VS Code, and here on fulfillment we have to enable the webhook, and here we will paste the link. For now we just go to the to-do, and the second step is done. Now we can create an npm project. For npm project, here the index.js. So first we need to go to terminal and init, we can do the init command npm init space y. Then here the JSON file is created. Let's look on it. Okay, now it will be done. Now we have to build index.js file. Okay, ignore this warning here. It will be just a nomenclature warning. So here we need to require some modules like first express, then we need to create an instance of a express module. Then we need to dialog flow fulfillment. And then Google APIs. Okay, go to the to do. Now what we can do? Okay, here we need to install our dependencies. Okay, so we need to, for install the dependency we need to npm install express. It will take some time. Okay, here another node one tool is created, and let's look into the JSON file. Here the dependencies, the express, add into dependencies, and now we need to install in dialog flow fulfillment. And Google APIs. Okay, this part is done, and we will specify a port to create a server. Then we need to specify this like const port. Yeah. let's say 3000. By default it will be 3000. Or if not any port is free, then it will be get automatically port from environment variable. For now, to create a server, the app is listening on port which will be 3000. Okay, this part is done. Now complete it, test it for responses. Okay, we can test for this intent. We need to add a map this intent in our VS code. So we will create a intent map which will be intent map. Then we have to map the intents. We need to set intent. Okay, we need to set this intent. With our function, this will be our function reminder add. And a last step is agent handle dot handle the request. We need to create a function. In this function, okay, we have for testing, we can just agent dot add, say that this response from VS code okay. Now we can save it and run it. For running, we can say that remove this thing and start. Here node index now we can just npm start to run this our project. Okay, here the error action. Actions on Google. Copy it and also need to install the action on Google. Okay, then we can go further. Just npm start. Okay, the server is running on 3000. The app is listening. Now we have to check in Dialogflow on reminder.add. Okay, let's say the hi. It will be our default welcome intent. So the response is this, and we need to just paste this thing here. Okay, here there's some problem. Okay, this is the unavailable. So go to the our VS Code editor. Okay, we need to specify here that this is the ingestion format. This will be our function and save it. Now run one more file. Now run more one more time. Let's check it for one more time. Okay, the response is here. The response from the VS Code editor. And here the entity is extracting the eat will be our event name. And here the date and the time. Time is just 8 p.m. Here. Okay, now we have just go to the to do and check it.